Right, we're off to pick up some steel and concrete blocks to take to Island Lake to try and open up the lumber factory or lumber mill, lumber yard, because we need to do that and another job before we can get on and do the rig on this one, drill rig on this one. So yeah, that's what we've done. I've White Western Star, done what updates and upgrades I can to it, flatbed so I can get two lots of blocks on that, and then a trailer for concrete blocks, or vice versa, doesn't really matter one way or the other. So I've got it all on there so I can get it across to Island Lake to deliver that to the lumber mill. And then once we're over there, I think we need to look at probably getting scout and opening up a few of the watch towers just so we can see what's around. This is a lot slower than the BM17. I haven't sold that. I did sell the International Trendstar I just recovered. No, I didn't. I kept that and I got rid of the Navstar. The Navstar I got, the pre-order one. That International Trendstar looks better in just the characteristics of the engineering when all the upgrades are on it. Yeah, it's actually slightly better. So whether it is going to be better in the long run, I don't know. We'll find out when we do, when we need to use it with to haul one of them big rig trailers, which we did with an Navstar not too badly. But we can put a high saddle on it and go from there. We've still got the Fisherman's Friend, which probably going to be left for later on. I'm going to try and run the main main storyline at the moment, just trying to get the third big part of the story on these maps done. Back for the other bits afterwards. Either that or we need to open them up just to upgrade, because at 11 we get an upgrade. I think we get spare wheel for the Trendstar, can't for the Western. The Western, I still think I need to be like 22 to get spare, which I think is quite high really for a spare wheel, because most vehicles would have spare wheel. You'd think that'd be one of the first things that will get unlocked. I don't think I've ever been out in a vehicle without a spare tyre or some means of puncture repair. It's quite a tight corner if you've got a very good turning circle. Still haven't used all-wheel drive on this yet. I have got it. It is engageable. Seems to be right. This is a long old route, and we'll come all the way back down as well. So this is going to be fun long route. This one, it's probably just going to be a video on its own, just this driving over there, getting it, coming back, opening up, because we've already got the other trailer there. So hopefully we should be able to get this delivered and then to pull that other trailer in and unload all that. There is a trailer with parts on. I need to grab that at some point. Let's see what happens. Haven't been inside this one yet. Let's jump inside this one and have a look. Oh, just at the wrong time on the corner. dodgy bridge will be coming up soon as well, won't it? The dodgy bridge crossing the Hummer. Get off them rocks. I'm doing the more damage. I haven't done a lot to the suspension, but the less damage I'll do, the better. Amazing. We're nearly there. Do a fuel station really as well. There's a trolley on there. I could have driven away and got the trolley from there. So they're towing one with me all the way. Right, here we go. This is the yard. Shield box. There we go. Let's go and spin around and load up on the way back out. Steel beams, load, and then we want to go to there. Concrete blocks. There we go. So let's go there. There we go. Nice, we should be able to get a nice picture out of that there. So then we come to there, settings, hard on. Continue. There we go. And we're back to normal. Because we need to have the hub on while we're driving. So let's see where we're going. So right, I need to follow this. Hold on. We need to go to have a look. I know it's not brilliant way of reversing, but let's see what happens. I don't know how far we'll be away from the Island Lake. Okay, we're there. Let's have a look at the map. Island Lake's there. Right, so I reckon if we just follow that, that's got to be a main road to there, isn't it? Following the main road. Right, back on Smithville Dam, let's do ourselves a route to where we want to go. So we need there. There. Come up past here because I can't remember how bad that was along there, and then we want to go to we want to go Island Lake, so we don't want to do that way at all, do we? We actually want to come down here, don't we? I reckon we can go here. Let's try that. We can only see what happens anyway, right. I will speed up this part of the journey as well, now that you've seen that the route we're taking, and so if you haven't listened to me, so enjoy. Right, after all that, and I've swapped over and everything, got it all going, I still think that BM17 is actually a better truck. It's nice, it's white Western style, it's got the four-wheel drive, it's really good. But I still just don't think, even though it says it's an S-rated engine on power, I still don't think it's got the oomph for the BM. About fuel capacity, it's probably about the same, isn't it? Right, so we're getting close anyway. We're getting close to getting through to the actual map. We've got to go make our way down to the right, let's go around. There we go, a bit of tarmac. Turn that off. We'll go through. Right, Island Lake. Anyway, all maps are open when we go into cross to the other one. We will miss the cutscene because we know where the cutscene is, and we need to get down to Broken Lumber. So there, that needs a bridge. So I think I ended up going all the way round, didn't I? So we're going there. Let's do that. Let's see what happens. Hopefully there's some fuel on the way. Can't remember how boggy this is from last time. So anyway, we'll do this. I'm probably going to speed this one up as well, unless something really crops up. So speak to you in a bit.